as like a advisory thing, or just like to check over the work, you know, something like that to help along the process.
Your name's not on the list, you
need
ain't
more
going.
Nerds. What you need?
I don't care about your guest list.
But you're not on the list, Wayne. You can't be there.
Well, I'm making myself on the list.
No, Wayne.
I remember there was an achievement for this. If you beat them all, like if you knock out all the goons, it gives you an achievement called Party Crasher.
Hey, you see, I missed that one. I didn't realize it was a thing. I just walked
down
the hallway.
If you beat all of them outside and in here, you get.
Well, most games don't usually have that as an option where you just, you know, because usually it's like, okay, it's a pre-established scene, so just, you know, go about your business. But I never realized that you could, in fact.
I didn't notice that until I played, when I played it again on the 360. Actually,
what, did you accidentally punch somebody?
No, I was just curious. No, it was when I played this on the Xbox One to 100% it.
Okay.
I don't know if it's gonna give me the Party Crasher when I hit the top this one. Yeah, no. I already got it because it brought it over from the Xbox One. But it'll like say achievement unlocked Party Crasher. It's one of those you kind of have to discover on your own, like the hidden room in the warden's office.
Yeah, how are anybody supposed to discover that on your own? I don't.
If nobody
understand.
Knows, you gotta have a little bit of a hint to get through it. How do the
I mean,
other
if
people
most,
find it?
Most walls only take one explosive gel, right?
And then you can't. You don't even see it behind.
Okay, you don't see it. And
but
then
that
you
was.
Tree.
But that was to let people know, hey, I think that was more of an Easter egg to let people know, hey, we're working on a sequel. And then in Arkham City, it's another hidden thing. It's on that barge where you see that prisoner freak, that one.
Yeah, the one where he's screaming and you got his scarecrow face on the TV.
Yeah.
Isn't there a real trophy there? So it kind of gives you an idea of how to get to the boat a little bit.
Well, what you do is you use your sequencer thing.
Yeah.
Use your sequencer, and like you'll hear Scarecrow's voice, and that's to let you know, hey, we're making another game. Like you have to find it, and I think that was their idea of like, if you find this, then you'll know that hey, we're working on a potential sequel. But after Arkham City, we got Arkham Origins, and then I think 2015 is when we got Arkham Knight, which I've honestly.
It came out that long ago.
And that game holds up really well. Like, I feel like, and I kind of talked. Me and Karen kind of talked about this, I believe, or I talked about it with someone. How games nowadays. They don't more focus on graphics. It's more performance.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, the game can have graphics from like the Xbox One or Xbox 360 era, but that doesn't mean it can necessarily run on those consoles anymore. It's all about performance. You know, what was put into the game internally. So like, you know, I think a good example is Dragon Age Inquisition when it came out in 2014 for the Xbox One and the Xbox 360, you can see a major difference. Like in the 360 version, because I played it, things take a lot longer to load, like graphic wise, because it wasn't meant to be on the 360. But you know, BioWare wanted a lot of people to buy because it had been like a year since the Xbox One came out, but not everyone could afford an Xbox One.
I didn't actually know there's a 360 version.
Of Dragon Age Inquisition, yes, there's a.
Yeah.
There is, sadly. And I will say it is. Because it takes, like, so much. But luckily, I do like the thing that they made it to where when people finally got an Xbox One, they could transfer whatever. So, whatever, however far you progress in the 360 version, you can transfer that data over to your Xbox One. So you didn't have to, like, start all over again.
Which is great, because that's a long one to have to start over again.
Yeah, it is. For,
oh,
like,
yeah, no, and I'm,
like that.
And I'm so glad that they're changing that they're getting rid of the big open world in Dragon Age Veilguard.
I haven't seen anything on that yet. I'm sure it'd be interesting, but if they're getting rid of that open world aspect,
well, it was an experimental thing because, you know, both came out around the time of like when games like Skyrim and The Witcher 3 were big, you know, big open world, yada yada. But like, I do like that they're going. From what I've seen, they're going back to like the old school Dragon Age 2 and 3. I mean, the Dragon Age 1 and 2 and Mass Effect 1 and 3, from what I've seen.
Good, because I feel like I played the first one quite a bit. I never touched the second one. I really like how the first one was, so if they go back to that, it's the right balance of feeling open world and having just linear, but still having to go be thorough on, you know, checking stuff or doing quests. So I'm all for that. Yeah, it took.
I feel like Dragon Age Inquisition, Mass Effect, and Drama, it was more about exploration and like missions.
Sure.
Which I get what you were trying to go for. I can upgrade.
But I didn't feel like it really landed what it was going for. Much like Starfield with exploration, like explore what? You know.
Oh yeah, no, like you can explore all these. I think what they were trying to aim for was like, you know, what's that one space exploration game?
No Man's Sky?
No Man's Sky. They were trying to do like a No Man's Sky thing, but like, I don't know. I feel like a lot of game companies really just promise this and that, but at the same time, they're like, we're promised A, B, C, and D, but all we see is like A.
Half of A,
and like. But No Man's Sky, you know, they were able to work on that, which I'm happy about.
The fact that they were able to come back from how barren of a game that was is incredible. The fact they kept all the updates free and then just start charging a whole bunch. You know, because at least they learned from their mistake, and I'm legitimately looking forward to the new game to work on, that Light No Fire.
Oh yeah, the one game I'm looking forward to, well, I played it, thankfully, was when they released, Cyberpunk 2077. You know how that turned out.
Yeah. But it's actually, you know what, not bad. I've played it since the Phantom Liberty came out. And it's good now.
That was like, I think that was like the intention. Like, you know, we want to work on this. You know, I mean, it came out in 2020. They wanted to, it was supposed to be an Xbox Series and PS5 release. But, they want, again, it's one of those, we know not everyone can afford the new console, so we'll be releasing them both. But, you know, the game's not going to be complete. And
I think all the people trying to buy up all the consoles and sell them at ridiculous prices. That didn't help any either.
No, that made.
I mean, I was able to finally get an Xbox Series, Xbox Series S, when taxes came in.
You know, I don't want anybody. I still like Xbox. Yeah.
It took us quite some time to get the PS5.
Oh yeah, no, I want to get the PS5 so bad, mainly because I want to replay the Final Fantasy VII remakes.
I need to finish that. Thank you for reminding me. But yeah, it's worth getting it.
There's remake, and then there's that interlude where you're playing as Yuffie.
How many are there? Like 17?
And then there's Final Fantasy Rebirth, which is the one that recently came out. And the thing is, you don't have to play through the other Final Fantasy games because they do a recap, but you don't, like, you know how, like, in the first three, you know, the original, how you can, like, transfer over all your stuff to, like, the next part? They don't do that. They kind of tweak it a bit so you're not, like, a low level when you start.
Okay.
And my assumption is, so there's going to be three parts. So my assumption is, part three is going to be called the Union.
Okay.
Which makes sense because it's Final Fantasy, Sephiroth, and I don't know how they're gonna, but I want to.
So,
I,
So are those DLC or standalone games?
The Final Fantasy series?
So like the Rebirth and the...
So Remake is part one, Rebirth is part two, and then Reunions could be part three.
Okay.
Because if you were to add combine, if you were to, it would be a very long game, and it would have taken a lot longer, and it probably wouldn't be able to run on a PS5. Giggling in a
corner and bleeding. But I do. Sure wouldn't.
And then Interlude is basically, you know, you're playing as Yuffie, but it like takes place during like each part of part one of Remake. Oh shit! Not this boss fight. But this is like the. This is an easier boss fight, if I'm going to be honest.
Yeah, I don't remember him being too much of a problem.
And I wish your dad and Sam were here to watch this. But, you know, I completely...
What, we not good enough for you?
Oh, no. I know, I'm glad you guys are here. But I get it, you know, it's summer, people want to go out and have fun, and I don't always expect the returning guests to come back for these. It's just, I've just come to realize it's more fun when I have people on, when I'm not doing like a game review. When I do a game review, I do, but like when I do like these, it's like, I want people to I'm not talking to them.
You
want to
be like talking to a wall?
I'm crazy.
Yeah, I'm so lonely.
I get a little lonely.
You know what I feel bad for? I feel bad for Joker when he was slowly turning back, like all his bones and everything must have moved. God, must have like hell. Titan Joker.
Yeah, that would hurt horribly. And then whatever cancer-like effect it had on him past that.
There was a thing I had in my mind, like, what if we had a DLC where you played as Joker? I mean, we have the DLC where he does, like, the fighting of, like, all the guards and everything, and the beat 'em up, but, like, what if there was, like, a separate DLC? Well, this is before DLCs. Because this came out in 2009. But, like...
They would have done something like that for Knight.
Oh, yeah, no.
Well, I mean, that one where you play as Batgirl, right? Oh, that was taking place before Arkham.
Oh, yeah,
the Asylum.
Oh, I know, I love that DLC.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Oh, yeah. You got to see Starro. You got to see Starro the Destroyer.
Oh, yeah, that's right, using that tank in the corner.
I forgot about that. It won't kill you to smile. Oh,
shit. I hate this fight.
I remember him having
this. He's had him. I had a friend ask me once, no longer friends, but like, asking how do I beat this part, because they were playing the game too. I first found out about this game because of YouTube. And when they
used to get good.
How was that round?
Well, I found out about this game back in like when they were announcing. Hell, I remember watching the cinematic trailer for. They showed it last time. We had to show the cinematic trailer for Arkham City. Yeah, I remember. Oh God. Yeah, it was. When Spike TV did the video game award and they were showing the game. Oh wait, fuck. Crap.
Game trailers just don't live up to the game, dude. Like, Dead Island, that's...
Oh yeah, Dead Island 2. Like, so we got Dead Island Riptide, and then the Dead Island game.
Can I get out of this?
Yeah, you know what, that wasn't bad. I played that on Game Pass.
Mm-hmm.
Not bad, I'm glad I didn't pay for it.
Oh yeah, oh, Dead Island 2, the official Dead Island 2, because the Dead Island 2 game has been, like, been in development hell for years.
Yeah, that one, people seem to be loving that one a lot better.
Oh. Oh, want to know something interesting?
Yes.
So Cyberpunk 2077, the very first cinematic trailer came out in 2013, because it was originally supposed to get a Xbox Series release. Yeah, so the game was in like development hell for like 7 years. I don't know what they were doing.
Yeah, it's quite a long time.
Dedicated to one thing.
I don't know, well, like CD Projekt Red was also in the midst of getting The Witcher 3 finished.
Which I've heard those are good games. I got the first one, no sorry, two with the games with gold on 360. Played a little bit of it.
Games with gold, man, I remember that.
Oh, I guess.
Remember games with gold? Oh, yeah, I knew that.
Pepper Tron remembers.
Pepper Tron remembers when Xbox. Oh, what's the day? Get your wife.
I'm not doing away with that.
But yeah, it was very unique. I just had a hard time getting into it.
I actually beat the main story to The Witcher 3. I never played the DLC.
The graphics
looked
amazing with the one I played. Bring
it on! I don't know which one. Can't level up anymore. Oh, I can't.
Oh, yeah?
Get on level up.
Boy, you've already made two great single hits already.
Oh, right?
There's not much leveling up left. I already leveled up all my health, my armor.
Yeah, you'll mix tracks.
Not gonna sit. You're in one of those mixed boards.
This is probably gonna be split into. We'll see. I'll see how long this footage is, because when Karen and I recorded last week, it was like a 38-minute episode. So this, I don't know if it's. I'll still probably do it in two parts, just for the lulz. Because, you know, Ivy boss fight is gonna be one, and then this fight will be another. This part will be another. I don't know. I haven't simply decided yet.
I just noticed how many board games you have.
Yes.
Do you play them all?
We've played just about almost all of them. There's like four or five that we haven't. One of them you have to have more than two people. It's the Infection Outpost 31. It's the Thing board game. But, you know, the problem is playing a board game like that. It's like, well, I know I'm not the thing, so you must be the thing. So,
Oh, I forgot there's a Thing board game. Do you know they're doing a remastered version of the Thing game that came out for the original PS2 and Xbox?
I wasn't sure if that was legitimate or not. I've seen a couple different Facebook posts and
that
stuff.
That is legit. They're basically doing what they did with, like, the Halo game, where they're not changing the voice actor, they're just remastering over the original game.
What? Are they going to do, like, Resident Evil stuff and add new stuff to it, or just reskin it?
It's just a reskin version of the original Xbox game.
Because there's parts where it was kind of difficult with how
basically
strafing and stuff like that works. So I kind of hope that they add a little bit to it. It doesn't have to be one-to-one.
They're basically doing like what they did with the Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary and the Fable Anniversary. Just basically keep all the original voices, but just give it a reskin. Yeah, pretty much.
Okay.
And then apparently we're getting another Starship Troopers game.
Quite a mess. Oh really? What game is that? And the
venom-enhanced inmates are returning to normal.
I know of Terror and Command, and I know of Extermination.
I'm looking it up right now.
Well, that should be cool.
I'll survive.
And I'm just waiting for people to see. They copied Helldivers! They copied Helldivers! Like, Helldivers took inspiration from Starship Troopers first.
Yeah, and Extermination, if that's one that they're saying, that came out before Helldivers 2. I mean, it's still an early release.
Everything's already been done and redone. You know,
there's only so much.
Creativity is only. You can only go so far without repeating what people have already done. You just have to find new ways to add to it, but it's all the same thing.
And if you make it very clear that it's a love letter to the things that, you know, you like, and it's not just like, hey, I like the idea. And stamp your name on it.
Oh,
then,
yeah. Okay. So October 11th, Starship Troopers Extermination is officially headed to PlayStation 5, Xbox Series, and PC on October 11th.
Yeah, I did hear about that. So it is the same game. I do have a computer, but I plan on getting it for console. Okay, it's reached the point to where with updates and stuff like that, my computer can't handle it anymore. And as a matter of fact, an interesting update that I find really cool that they're adding is they're calling it the Carnage update. So all the bugs' bodies no longer disappear. So they do what they did in the movies. They'll start piling up and be able to walk over the corpses and get in. And the only way to stop that is destroying the bodies. But they'll dynamically start moving around and using their corpses to get at you, which sounds fantastic. Well, hi, Wayne.
Hi. Let me just... We already know what happens at the end. Well, yeah. I know that was kind of short-lived, but we finally just finished the Arkham... After a year since we first started it, we finally finished Batman Arkham Asylum. Eventually, I do want to go back to... real quick announcement. Eventually, we will be starting, since it's on Game Pass, we will be starting a 7 Days to Die series soon.
Yes!
It's gonna be a limited series. It's gonna be called Surviving 7 Days. And then eventually we are going to be doing, because I want to try it. Well, I don't know how that would, actually, I don't know how that would work, because I would have to get footage from you guys. So I don't know how that would work. But if there's a way I can get your guys' footage, I would love to do a, well, actually, I think I could do spectator mode. I got to see how, if spectator mode is a thing. Because if it is, the Xbox. I wonder if there's a spectator mode. I got to find out if there's a spectator mode. If there is, then we can do a second series called Trying to Survive Till Horde Night, where basically it is a permadeath run to see who can survive up to Horde Night, or if they can survive the Horde Night.
Might as well not include Karen right out the gate. She'll be dead within 5 minutes. But
I do want to do a 7 Days to Die series, and then when
I'm dead day one,
and then when Space Marine 2 comes out, I definitely want to do that, because they have a co-op mode by the looks of it.
Yes, which is going to be great.
Oh, yeah.
So
yeah,
I'd be down for that as well.
But yeah,
exciting.
Well, I think that should do it, you guys. I know this was kind of short, but I got work in the morning, and I know you guys have work and everything too. Cannot wait to see you and your dad at Con the next month. It's gonna be really fun, especially since they got 2 Star Wars actors now as guests.
Oh really? Yeah. Who they got?
So they got Spencer Wilding, for those who are listening to this, if you want to check it out, because I'll be there as a media guest. They got Spencer Wilding. He wore the Darth Vader suit in Rogue One. And I can't remember the guy's name because it's really hard to pronounce. So I'm not going to try to pronounce it. But he played as a Gamorrean guard at Jabba's Palace in Return of the Jedi.
Oh, really? Nice.
Yeah. So that's going to be pretty fun to see. Real quick, as always, as you guys know, I always ask, starting with you, Karen, would you like to drop your links below so people can find you on social media to stay up to date with your cosplays and stuff?
Yeah, it's... Red and then the _ rogue and then _ assassin on Instagram and Facebook.
And not to be confused with their sister Sam, because you can tell the difference between Sam and Karen now.
Yeah, I have a red hood for mine.
Yeah. And Brandon, where can people find you on the social medias? Because I know you say you have a Facebook page, and I need to find it so I could put it in the links below.
Erodrin Cosplay and Art. I'm not super up on that stuff. So
I'll have you send me your Facebook link or page in the chat so I can add it. So I like, cause I can't remember how to spell that.
Yeah, no problem. That is kind of an issue. It's simple to spell, but it doesn't sound like it.
Yeah. It's not like long, but yeah, I wouldn't be able to spell it.
And you all know where you can find me. As always, I'm Wayne the Unknown. Until next time. Wait, what am I doing? I'm going to do another outro after this, probably, and post. But yes, as always, I'm Wayne the Unknown. Until next time, thank you for listening. And as always, thank you for watching.